Hindi naman na nakakagulat na iisa ang fingerprints ni Guo Huaping at Mayor Alice Guo sa COMELEC records. Napatunayan na nga ng NBI na iisang tao lang sila. Gayunpaman, nakakakilabot pa rin na may Chinese national na naging alkalde ng isang bayan sa Pilipinas. This also affirms the various lapses in the laws and regulations of many institutional systems, from the PSA to the COMELEC. Kaya patuloy ang aming hearing sa Senado para matugunan ang mga pagkukulang na ito. Patuloy din ang ating panawagan kay Guo Huaping na kusa ng magpakita. Hindi matatahimik ang buhay niya sa patuloy na pag-iwas sa Senado. Hindi lang basta-bastang Chinese ang nagtago sa sinasabing bahay ni Harry Roque. Itong si Sun Liming ay bigating pugante na nasa red notice ng Interpol. Sabi ni Roque, ang may-ari ng bahay ay ang PH2 Corporation, na ang majority shareholder ay Bian Cham Corporation, kung saan incorporator siya at mga associates niya. Inamin din ni Roque na may bantay siya mismo sa bahay at supervise niya ang nangyayari dun. Kaya nakapagtataka na sa dami ng bahay sa Pilipinas, kay Roque pa talaga napunta ang pugante. Ayon sa PAOK, IT manager si Lining ng Lucky South 99, ang POGO na tinutulungan ni Roque aregluhin ang mga utang sa PAGCOR. It appears this fugitive and Roque run in the same circles. Nakakabahala ang dami ng mga dayuhang kriminal na nasa bansa pa dahil sa POGO. While a ban was already announced, we in the Senate need to craft measures to ensure that this industry never comes back again.
And as corporate secretary, sir.
And your participation was limited to that purpose lang, no? Yung negotiation as to the payment for the fees that were not paid. Tama po ba?
Yes, Your Honor. And 2 weeks later, they retained me to handle the ejectment case, specifically a motion to quash.
Just in relation to PAGCOR lang.
Yes, yeah. Your Honor. That's it.
Okay,
yes,
now, two meetings ago kasi, Mr. Chair, I remember that Altenco, during questioning by Congressman Adjong, mentioned that he was of the impression that Attorney Roque wasn't just lawyering for Whirlwind, but was in fact lawyering for Lucky South 99. And this is contrary to what you said was a statement of Altenco. I wanted that to be clarified po sana.
He was wrong because at that time po that we met, and Attorney Jeza Fernandez can confirm this, on July 26, 2023, the official representative of Lucky South with PAGCOR was Mr. Dennis Cunanan.
Okay, now Attorney Fernandez, you were with Altenco when you were meeting with Attorney Roque, is that correct?
Yes.
And do you remember two meetings ago that Altenco also mentioned that he was of the impression that Attorney Roque was lawyering for Lucky South 99 and not just Whirlwind? Is that also correct?
Yes, sir.
So he said that, correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now
he just said that. He just said yes. Are you of the impression that he was lawyering for Lucky South?
Yeah.
He said yes.
Yes, correct. Now, you were also present. Was that also the same impression that you shared with Altenco?
I am not one to assume, sir, but the topic of the meeting that we had with him, sir, was really Lucky South 99.
And what was specifically the topic as far as Lucky South 99 is concerned?
It's about the arrears of Lucky South 99, which were not remitted to PAGCOR, allegedly because its authorized representative did not deposit said amount to PAGCOR's account.
Okay, now, you also heard Attorney Roque parang downplayed it kanina. Sabi niya, it wasn't for the renewal naman of the permits because the permits was still good for a few more years. That's what he said. But why would then he meet with you guys if it had nothing to do with the permits of Lucky South 99?
I think in addition to the topic of the non-payment of arrears of Lucky South 99, it was also that period when we already released the new guidelines for internet gaming licenses. So, Lucky Sal, the Miss Cassandra Ong would like to reapply, expressed her intent to reapply under the new framework, and that she was informed that she has to comply with the requirements and to pay for the arrears before the application may be processed.
Okay, so it now crossed just from the payment of arrears to the new requirements of the IGL. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
And was Attorney Roque participating in that discussion?
Based on what I remember, nakikinig lang po siya doon.
Okay. Now, you also mentioned that there were several phone calls that were made by Attorney Roque to you.
Yes,
you confirm
sir.
That?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what was the nature of these conversations?
He was asking po kung meron pa pong lacking documents yung Lucky South.
So it is for the new accreditation of Lucky South 19 as IGL?
Yeah, for the ongoing application po of Lucky South for an internet gaming license.
So it is contrary to the statement that it was just for the payment of the arrears?
I cannot answer that, sir, but matter of fact lang po,
yeah,
that the follow-ups po were made for the application of Lucky South 99 as an internet gaming license.
And no discussions were made as far as Whirlwind is concerned?
None po, because Whirlwind po does not have any relationship or any accreditation or any relationship or contractual relationship with AgCorp.
How about the phone calls that you received from Attorney Roque? Did it include in any way Whirlwind?
No po.
No. So it was all Lucky South 99?
Yes po.
Okay. How many calls were that, if you recall?
Around 5 to 6, sir, but I missed 2, sir.
Okay. Now, Attorney Roque, to be fair po, I'll give you time to explain din po.
Yes. The explanation po is because Kasi Ong is a service provider. Not only do they own the premises, but they provide services to Lucky South. It's a matter of record and documentation that the official representative as of July 26, 2023 was Dennis Conanan, and therefore the document is proof itself, no, that on the time that we met, it was Dennis Conanan. Now, in that meeting, nagsalita rin po si Chairman Altenco, and I'm sure si Attorney Fernandez will recall, sabi niya hindi ko gusto yan Dennis Conanan. Hindi talaga mabuting tao yan. I suggest palitan yan. At kaya po, napalitan si Dennis Conanan. I do not know if Attorney Fernandez recalls that, no? And of course, by being a representative of a licensee to PALCOR, hindi naman po requirement na ikaw ay maging shareholder, hindi rin requirement na ikaw ay maging officer, because Dennis Conanan in fact was neither an officer or a shareholder. Ang kinakailangan lang po is a board resolution authorizing that person to represent that company to PALCOR. So consistent po yan sa sinasabi ko na Whirlwind provides services, and after that meeting, upon suggestion of Altenco, dahil hindi nga maganda daw reputasyon ni Dennis Conanan, eh tinanggap nga niya yung representative na hindi naman po required na maging kabahagi ng korporasyon. Ulitin ko po ha, ang service provider po importante sa mga POGO kasi hindi po yung mga nag-i-English. Wala,
sir,
at saka
yes,
nasa POGO hub po sila, di sila lumalabas po.
Thank you, sir. For a while, sali lang po. Kasi I also watched your interviews and your statement before the Senate. Parang what you said kasi was like, it was just purely Whirlwind. You were in no way connected with Lucky South 99. But you also heard Attorney Fernandez na sabi niya na from all intents and purposes, ang appearance that you were giving was that you were asking about the renewals, the requirements na nga for Lucky South 99. Now, how is that related to being just the lawyer for the service provider?
Madali po i-explain.
Sige po.
Kasi yung kliyente ko na Whirlwind acts as an agent for Lucky Star, Lucky South. So it is an agency. Yung service provider po, in effect, is a contract of agency. Siyang gumagalaw para po sa Lucky South. So when I represented the Whirlwind, it is because I was representing an agent of Lucky South, but not Lucky South. But I state under oath as a former member of this house, as an officer of the court, I have never had any dealings with any officer or stockholder of Lucky South. Kaya nga po, alam niyo naman ang attorney-lawyer relationship, it's the highest fiduciary relationship. Hindi ko po talaga po pwedeng akuin na kliyente ko siya, bagamat sana po kinuha ko dahil tingin ko makakwash ko yung raid sa kanilang premises. Yun po yung sinasabi ko sa Senado. Dahil yeah, mali po talaga yung mga ginawa dun sa raid na yon. Kung ako'y maniningil na 10% contingency on the basis of the value of the land, yayaman na po ako, no? Pero, yes, ayaw po nila ako kunin. Siguro po kasi ang impression nila kapag may problema na ang gusto nilang kunin, isang abogado na malakas sa gobyerno at hindi po kritiko.
Okay po. But please understand din po na from what Attorney Fernandez is saying, I mean from someone who's listening lang po from what she was saying, is that it's no longer just as a lawyer for Cassandra Leong. Kasi you're now asking about the requirements for the renewal of the IGL. So parang it's no longer just a service provider. As a service provider, siguro you'd provide other things other than securing their renewal of their permits. Would that be ano ba fair to say na ang agent nga lang as a service provider, siya pa naglalakad for the renewal of the permits from PAGCOR?
Totoo po, kasi nung panahon na yon na revoke na yung appointment ni Dennis Cunanas as representative to PAGCOR. So it was already Cassandra Ong. After that meeting, that became the representative of Lucky South.
Of but whom you represent?
I represented her because she's an employee, corporate secretary of Orwin.
Kaya nga po. So, apo. Siya nagiging representative ng Lucky South 99 at ikaw yung abogado niya. Tama po ba?
Well, abogado
from
po
your explanation po ngayon.
Well, yun po, dahil ang Whirlwind nga po ay ahente.
No. It was Cassandra Leong who was the agent of, you said, di ba? Sabi mo, pinalitan niya si Dennis Cunanan. Siya na ang naging representante ngayon ng Lucky South 99. At ikaw yung abogado niya. So, you are now lawyering for a representative of Lucky South 99.
I correct? Disagree po. Kasi po, ang Cassandra Ong was there as part of Whirlwind. So I was representing for Cassandra Ong of Whirlwind, acting as representative of Lucky South. That is a more accurate po. And pursuant to the laws of agency po.
Isn't that
po
like stretching the definition na rin po?
Hindi naman po. Kasi okay, kung ako po talaga yung nag-lawyer for Lucky South, ang tanong ko, wala pong masama doon. Pero ang punto, hindi po talaga ako nag-lawyer.
Hindi lawyer for Lucky South 99. I'm just saying, na as you said, Cassandra Leong replaced Dennis Cunanan as the agent of Lucky South 99. And you are the counsel for the representative of Lucky South 99. Yun lang po. I'm not saying directly to Lucky South 99, but of the agent of Lucky South 99.
I was representing Kasi Ong of Whirlwind. That is correct po. And I confirm that.
Secretary Roque, I think yes, ma'am. You read the rules a while ago.
Yes, sir.
Please follow the rules. Address the chairman.
My apologies. My apologies po. It's just that it was an animated discussion and a friendly discussion. After all, he's also from a province of my relative who's now governor.
Yeah, sir. Yun lang po. I was just confused. Para I wanted it to be clear lang. Kasi I think Altenco should be here para at least man lang to clarify din yung statement niya. Kasi doon nga ako nalito eh. Kasi when he appeared 2 meetings ago, he categorically said kasi na he was of the impression that you were lawyering for Lucky South 99. And contrary to what you were saying also, Mr. Chair, that he never mentioned or he denied that you were lawyering for Lucky South 99 po.
Mr. Chair, I guess my answers is based on actual rules of legal ethics on when there is engagement. There could be an engagement between attorney and client as simple as giving legal advice. But there is an actual legal engagement when there's actually a contract between a client and attorney. So yun po yung talagang status sa legal ethics. Minsan, Mr. Chairman, yung mga nagtatanong sa radyo, yan po yung mga issue. Kasi pagbibigay pa lang ng legal advice, may attorney-client relationship na. Pero para magkaroon po ng engagement, dapat talaga merong kasunduan. Bakit naman po ako magre-represent, Mr. Chairman, isang kumpanya hindi magbabayad sa akin? Abay, mayaman pa, pogo pa.
Okay,
sisingiling ko po yan, Mr. Chairman. Wala naman po akong nahita.
Okay.
Then, maraming salamat po.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Now, last, Mr. Chair, just to be clear lang, no, para idugtong ko lang. You're saying that you are representing Cassandra Leong as a representative of Whirlwind. But at the same time, you also said that Cassandra Leong replaced Dennis Cunanan as a representative of Lucky South 99 in relation to the application of Lucky South 99 to with PAGCOR in the renewal of their permits. And that was confirmed by Attorney Fernandez that you made several calls to her in relation to also the requirements for the renewal of the permits for Lucky South 99. Para clear lang po, no? So it's not you directly to Lucky South 99, but you with Cassandra Leong. But on the issue lang na medyo Cassandra Leong was acting for both Whirlwind and Lucky South 99. Tama po ba?
Well, aywan ko po kung tama na for both kasi siya po talaga ang naging representative as Whirlwind. Pero naalala ko po kung bakit ako tumawag. Kasi ang sabi po niya, hindi nga raw makontakt si Attorney Jessa. And even me, when I called twice, hindi po ako nasagot. So nakiusap lang po siya na baka naman pag kayo po tumawag, malaman ko kung ano pa yung kulang namin. And that is why I complied naman with the request of Asiong dahil sabi naman talaga ni Attorney Hernandez, mahirap talaga siya makontakt. And nakontakt ko naman po siya at least 3 times. No? Isa by text. Yun nga pong hiningi ko lang yung ano yung lacking documentary requirements. Nasa akin pa po yung sagot niya. And isa-isa niya. Tapos pangalawa, tawag, sinabi ko lang na meron ng abogadong magre-represent sa Lucky South para dun sa MTTP. Kasi yan po yung bagong requirement na wala talaga nakakaintindi. Pero hindi po akong gumawa nun. Ibang abogado po yung gumawa nun. At pangatlo, tinanong ko lang kung ano yung status at dun nga po sinabi na on the basis of media reports and on the basis of the investigation banban, they're not inclined to approve. At sinabihan ko naman po si Cassie na, uy, ipasarado mo yung pogo na yan dahil illegal na yan kapag mag-operate. At tumunod naman po. Maraming salamat, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. To Yusek Cruz, sir. The persons that you picked up sa Benguet, they Attorney Roque said that he was not involved with Pogo. Would you confirm that, sir? Can you confirm that he was not in any way related to any Pogo activities ba?
Are you referring to the person
the Chinese
that was
guy
arrested?
Who claimed to be Cambodian ba?
Yes, sir. Under investigation pa rin, sir, yung involvement niya rin sa Porak, Pogos niya.
Is it true that he's parang sa IT siya? Involved siya sa IT?
Yes, sir. Just to give you a background, sir, of Sun Liming. This Sun Liming, sir, is his Chinese name, sir. Ito yung totoo niyang identity. Last September 15, sir, 2023, yung mga assets niya po was froze by the Chinese government dahil sir dun sa liming.com. Ito sir yung platform na ginagamit niya para makapanlo. And nakapanloko po siya amounting to 64 million yuan. And eventually they discovered it na mas malaki pa pala yung naloko niya amounting to 7 billion yuan. Ang mga niloko nito sir are mostly Chinese people. And kung isipin natin sir, yung 7 billion yuan na yun, it's close to 56 billion pesos. Sir. So Mr. Sun and his cohorts dupe yung victims nila in believing into that their company sir ay isang multiple contracts, nakakuha ng multiple contracts from the Chinese government. Pinalabas nila, sir, na marami silang contracts from the Chinese government. And yun po, sir, yung modus operandi nila in their scam.
Is there truth to the rumors that siya din yung IT person in charge sa yung mga scam farms?
Yun po sir kasi yung background niya sir is considered to be a genius pagdating sir sa paggawa sir ng mga apps ng mga scamming hubs.
So wala pang results sa investigation niyo?
Iniimbestigahan pa po natin in coordination sir with the Chinese embassy.
Okay. Thank you Mr. Chair. Thank you Attorney Roque. Thank you Attorney Fernandez.
Thank you Your
thank
Honor.
You, Pong.
Before we proceed further, Madam Chair, acknowledge the presence of our Deputy Majority Leader, the Honorable Janet Garin, 1st District, Iloilo. Congressman Paduano is not here. Congressman Bong Teves is not here. The Honorable Adjong is now recognized for your interpellation.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Magandang hapon po sa ating lahat. Before I go on with my question, gusto ko lang pong klaruhin kay Attorney Fernandez. Attorney Fernandez, you were present during the previous hearing, no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, and you were, and when we were asking Chairman Teves about the nature of the meeting that happened took place between him and Ms. Ong, Sandra Ong. And I believe Secretary Roque was also present, as he also admitted. And correct me if I'm wrong, although I was actually, Mr. Chair, trying to secure the transcript of the previous meeting, because the question that we asked him is what's the nature and why Secretary Roque was present during that meeting. And he said that in no way was what in that meeting, in no way was the word or Whirlwind Corporation was even mentioned. Is it correct? Is my memory serves me right?
Yes.
That there's no mga parang sa discussion nila, Whirlwind Corporation was never mentioned.
Yes, sir. Based on my recollection po, hindi po na, yun po ang sinabi.
Yes, yun po ang sinabi niya. So now, Secretary Roque saying that he was there to, I don't know, sir, no, you were lawyering for Whirlwind and not sa Lucky South.
Opo, kasi nga po dun sa mga kaso, na actual kaso na hinarapan ko sa hukuman, dun po lumalabas ko anong relasyon ng Whirlwind at ang Lucky South. Kaya nga po, ejectment case yan dahil sila nagpaupa sa Lucky South. At kaya naman po din sila tumutulong dahil bukod pa dun sa pagpapaupa, patakaran naman ng mga nagpapaupa na nagbibigay din ng serbisyo, kasi nga po hindi nag-i-English yung mga yan. No? Kaya nga po, meron silang separate representative sa PAGCOR dahil hindi
yes,
sila
Secretary,
makarating.
Sorry po.
Opo.
Secretary, napakinggan ko na po yan, and then the same answer that you gave to the Senate Committee. No?
Yes,
I was actually watching and tama po. Ang di ko lang po maintindihan now, Mr. Chair, is that since you were there, yes, you, based on your testimony and your narrative, you were there simply because Whirlwind Company is a realty company that is actually owned the plot where Lucky South 99 is located. Am I correct? No? But now, if we go back to the records, Secretary Tengco said that hindi po napag-usapan yung Whirlwind. So, dun lang po ako nagkakaroon ng medyo confusion dahil po kung, of course, Mr. Secretary Roque, admit mo man o hindi, you are a known personality. Alam naman po yan eh. You are nationally known. So, I'm sure kung may pupunta ho kayo doon sa isang pagmi-meeting, I'm sure yung kausap niyo po talaga ay magtatanong kung bakit ho kayo nandoon. And since Chairman Tengco never mentioned anything about Whirlwind Company, and that's where confusion comes in. Kasi you are being attributed as the one lawyering for South 99, and yet you're saying that you are not. You're there simply because you are representing Whirlwind Company. So ganun lang po. Sa common na tao, ordinaryo na tao tulad namin, I'm not a lawyer. And the way I understand this is bakit ganun? Bakit po si Chairman Tengco is saying na hindi ho namin yun napag-usapan? In fact, he mentioned that kasi as a response to, I think, the you've written an editorial, I think a piece, no? And some in one of the major circulation. And sabi nga niya, according to him, that was your reasoning, no? And he read your piece, no? And as a response to that, sabi niya, there was never any moment in that meeting that Whirlwind Company was mentioned. So, ano po yung, gusto ko lang pong maliwanagan ako, Secretary Roque.
Mr. Chair, siguro po para mabigyan ng kalinwanagan yan, and Attorney Fernandez can in fact corroborate this, para ikaw maging representante ng isang kumpanya na may lisensya sa PAGCOR, dapat merong special power of attorney or board resolution authorizing you. So, ibig sabihin po niyan, pwede ka magkaroon ng representante na isang tao na hindi po stockholder at hindi po officer ng licensee mismo. O pwede po sila magtalaga ng kahit sino. At ang tinalaga po nila dyan ay si Cassie Ong, na hindi po siya officer, hindi po siya stockholder ng Lucky South. Pero inauthorized naman po siya matapos ng pagpupulong ng July 26. Kasi nga ang problema nila na dinulog kay Chair AU kanilang representante na napalitan. So, okay. Yun lang po yun para hindi po malabo.
Sige, salamat po. Nandito pa po yung SEC Security and Exchange Commission. I represent, Mr. Chair, do we have a representative here? Would you be so kind enough as to take a seat so that I can ask you clarificatory questions? Have you taken your oath, sir? Were you present during the previous meeting? Tama. Please, sir, you were listening naman during the indie exchanges, no? Sabi po kanina ni Secretary Roque is that he was there as a lawyer for Whirlwind Company, no? And the Whirlwind Company, if I'm got it right, explanation is that they own the land and they're also providing auxiliary services for OGO, in this case, Lucky South 99. What is the license actually? Matanong ko nga, ano pa yung license na nakuha po ng Whirlwind Company sa inyo?
Your Honor, ang kanilang pong primary purpose is to engage in realty development.
Okay.
The secondary purpose is to establish and operate a call center. Second is to engage in wholesale trading of any kind of goods and merchandise, including but not limited to food, beverage, and related products. To engage in general construction. Yun lang po nakalagay sa ano na.
Yung sinasabi po kanina ni Secretary Roque that Whirlwind Company also do services aside from leasing the space, providing auxiliary services, and I believe this is the yung mga services na yung sinabi po niya kanina, kasaklaw po ba ng kanilang lisensya,
Your Honor,
as a realty company?
Your Honor, ang dating po sa amin,
hindi dapat. Oho. So, kaya nga po, can you expound on that? Because ang pagkakaintindi ko po, Mr. Chair, kaya nga po ako nagtatanong dahil sabi nga nila, if you use your common sense, that's the most virtuous of all, most precious of all virtues. You use your common sense. My understanding is, it's a realty company. It's supposed to be the license. Supposed to be the business really is to lease, primarily lease the land, yes. Piece of land. And if there are auxiliary services inclusive of that, for example, that license, and then you'll be hiring people, you need to get additional license for that, at least. Or permits, right?
Or at least include it in your purpose.
Yes. Now, can you expound to this committee? Kasi yung pong nagkakaroon ng problema tayo because Secretary Roque is claiming that he can be a lawyer to any organization or any company naman . Wala namang problema doon. But now we are trying to really understand yung meeting na yon nangyari. And so he claims that he's there for the Whirlwind Company precisely because this company it does not only own the land, but they are also involved in providing services to their client, which is in this case the Lucky South 99, who represented at that time during the meeting by Ms. Cassandra Ong, wanting to get a permit for the IGL, the new guidelines, no? And the proviso there is she needs to pay for the $500,000 RERs that according to her, she's paying this to Andrew Kunanan, right? So that's, you make you get it? Yes, okay. So can you clarify to me, Mr. Chair, SEC, tama po ba na, limbawa po, si Secretary Roque sinasabi, nandoon tapos yung mga auxiliary services, parte po ba at saklaw po ba ng lisensya ng Whirlwind Company yung mag-provide sila ng auxiliary services for the end user, in this case, Lucky Strike 99, considering that their license is only for a realty company?
Last two questions, Congressman Ajong.
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Based po Your Honor, do sa conversation kanina, yung palitan po ng mga information, I am in opinion na...
Can you speak closer to the microphone and louder po?
In the opinion na hindi po siya saklaw. Ultra vires po tawag sa amin. Hindi po siya authorized.
Ano po?
Ultra vires.
Ultra vires. Okay, just to be fair, yeah. Just to be fair po, Secretary Roque, you heard naman po ang response ng SEC. And being a lawyer, all of us here would admit that when it comes to legal issues, you're one of the best-minded there is.
Yes.
Yes, my question po. Sabi po ng SEC is according to the license, they're not supposed to do and engage in extra or auxiliary services for your client. No? And I'm sure you already knew this, no? Before you even accept your whatever your contract or agreement with this company as their lawyer. So what can you say about that explanation of SEC na hindi dapat sila ang kumpanya mo na magbigay ng ganong klaseng serbisyo sa Lucky 9, SEC Strike 99?
Well, again po, no, there's a distinction between being illegal and being outside of mandate. Pero sa akin po, dalawang bagay. Nung nasa gobyerno po ako, at katabi ko naman si Chairman Domingo, nung panahon ng COVID, na kinailangan ng explain sa taong bayan kung bakit pinabuksan ang mga BPOs kasama na ang mga pogos ng panahon ng quarantine, nagbigay po ng briefing sa akin si Twinkle Valdez at nakilala ko rin po yung Association of Pogo Service Providers. Sila po talaga yung mga nakikicommunicate sa publiko kasi nga po, hindi pwede mag-communicate sa publiko ang mga pogo. Karamihan po talaga ng pogo providers, sila talaga nagmamayari at least ng physical staff. So, yan po ang pagkakaalam ko at yan din naman ang explanation sa akin ni Ati kung anong relasyon nila. Pangalawa po, siguro naman from a business point of view, maiintindihan ninyo na kapag may nangyari sa umuupa sa iyong property na wala na pong ibang purpose kundi para sa pogo, mawawalan ka ng kita. Kaya hindi nyo naman po matatanggal na yung mga nagmamayari na nagpapaupa ay concerned din po na magpatuloy talaga yung negosyo na nagbabagayad sa kanila ng pa. Now, ang ultra vires naman po, hindi po yan illegal. At yung ginagawa naman ng mga lessees at service providers, whether or not it is expressly provided in their articles of incorporation, maintindihan po natin yan as a proper business decision dahil ang interest nila, mabayaran sila ng pa.
Well, thank you very much. Ang hindi ko lang maintindihan, okay, it's beyond the capacity or beyond what the SEC allowed them to engage into business, no? Yun ang pagkakaalam ko po sa ano. Would you agree with that SEC that it may not necessarily be illegal even if kasi ang nakita ko po is if you got the license, for example.
Delete the text. That will be your last question.
A last question?
Yes.
And then last question and manifestation na lang po, Mr. Chair.
Okay.
Just to be clarified, no? If you are to be granted a license and engage in a huge business, we're talking about offshore gaming corporation and companies. It involves foreign entities here, right? So you do not only provide space for your end user or your client, but you as well, if taken your explanation, you'll also be providing space for the workers. Etc. Services, ilaw, etc. So you'll be employing so many people, no? SEC, Secretary, SEC. I'm sorry, SEC and SEC. What? How would you? How would you? Ano? How would you? Consider, for example, this in the case of this particular topic. Illegal ba ito o dapat talaga tanggalin or do you still continue on tolerating this kind of practices? Kasi pag ang pagkakaalam ko sa mga simpleng lisensya yan, hindi ka dapat nag-go beyond what is permitted for you to engage in or engage with, no? Ano yung position niyo diyan, no? Kasi para sa akin,
Yeah, it may not necessarily be illegal, but if it's contravenous, that's beyond your power, it's beyond your capacity or beyond your authority to do so, it simply means that you cannot, no? Right?
Your Honor, sa amin ho, pag ultra-virus is a ground for revocation,
yes.
we revoke the license.
The license. Na-revoke po yung license ng Whirlwind Company.
Ngayon pa lang ho namin nalaman itong information na ganyan. So, we will pursue
the investigation. Can you look into that? Ano?
Yes, Your Honor.
So, if I may be allowed, Mr. Chair, just one last lang po. One last.
One last question. Sige, go ahead, please.
Okay. Thank you. Maraming salamat po. Ngayon, I was listening po sa mga questions po kanina ni Congressman Keith Flores, no? Kasi parang ang ini-imply really is, okay, so Secretary Roque was lawyering for Whirlwind Company, but the end, the effect and the implication of this lawyering for that company is in effect, and by implication, ang magbe-benefit ang Lucky 9 South 99. Parang ganun eh, that's the effect, di ba? Gusto ko lang pong malaman na Secretary Roque, dahil alam ko po masyado kayong malaki ang saklaw ng inyong kaalaman sa batas. Ano po yung ibig sabihin? Can you define to me the practice of yung sinasabi nilang when yung sinabi po ng Supreme Court defined as the practice of law? Can you enlighten me kung what does it mean by the Supreme Court saying that, you know, defined to us, ano po yung practice of law? Kasi narinig ko rin po sa inyo, I think yesterday or in one of your interviews, you've mentioned about the practice of law. And would you categorize, for example, not necessarily lawyering for Cassandra Ong, but, you know, using your own profession in law, not necessarily having agreement or contract with Lucky South 99, but your actions may otherwise benefit this company, a definition of a practice of law?
Well, una-una po, for you to have a practice of law, dapat may kliyente po.
Uh-huh.
Now, dapat alam mo kung sinong kliyente. Now, it may be that acts that you do for a client may benefit another entity because they have a mutual interest. At ganyan po nangyari dito dahil syempre yung Whirlwind gusto nila magpatuloy yung negosyo ng kanilang kliyente at ang Lucky South din gusto magpatuloy sa kanilang kliyente. Pero wala pong attorney-client relationship kung hindi po talaga nagkasundo yung abogado at ang kliyente.
So, yeah. Okay po. So, would you, in the layman's, gusto lang po yes or no po. With everything that you have done for Whirlwind Company, would you at least admit to this committee that in a way nag-benefit po yung Lucky South 99?
Nag-benefit, pero wala po ko kahit anong transaction with anyone from Lucky South, whether be it stockholder or officer.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. That would be my last question.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Secretary Roque.
Now, we will be
Chairman.
Proceeding with the next interpellator, Congressman Chairman Abante. Sir, you are recognized.
Thank you, Chair. Tony Roque, kapatid.
Yes, Bishop. Good afternoon. My Bishop. Kong Bishop.
You admit kanina when Congressman was asking you na sinamahan nyo ang isang POGO executive kay Pagcor Chairman Altenco. Am I right?
Hindi po. Kasi ang pagkakakilala ko, hindi po POGO executive si Cassie Ong. Siya po ay taga Whirlwind.
All
siya
right.
Po ay nagpapaupa at service provider nga po sa isang POGO licensee.
So, hindi niyo pa alam at that time?
Alam ko po. Kasi matagal ko nang kakilala, isang taong ko na rin kakilala po ang Whirlwind. Dahil kinoconvince ko nga po sila na mag-invest sa isang renewable energy project.
So, hindi niyo sinamahan ano pangalan nun? Cassandra Ong, hindi nyo sinamahan because of POGO.
Well, ang problema po nila ay yung kanilang kliyente na umuupa ng kanilang premises ay nagkaroon ng problema. Mga Chino po yan, hindi naman nag-i-Ingles at ang problema nila dun sa representante nila sa PAGCOR mismo.
So, bakit nyo kinakailangang puntahan ng personal si Altenco tungkol dito?
Kasi kinakailangan po ng board approval. And the chairman, of course, is the chairman of the board of PAGCOR. Hindi po ito ma-approve sa level labang ni Attorney Fernandez. Kinakailangan magkaroon po ng board resolution adopted by the PAGCOR board to authorize a rescheduling of payment.
Mm. So, naniniwala rin po kayo doon sa tinatawag nating political influence.
Well, yan po ay katotohanan. Pero ang katotohanan din po, sinabi naman po ni Chairman Altenco, hindi po kami magkakilala, bagamat meron din po mga Roque sa Malolos where he was once a mayor.
Okay.
Mr. Chair.
Kapatid, you admitted na abogado kayo ng Whirlwind Company po ba yan?
Opo, Mr. Chair, at nagsubmit na po ako ng mga dokumento na may tatlong kaso akong hinawakan, pero lahat po yan related doon sa property sa Porac.
Kayo po ba ay naka-retainer o meron kayong specific contract?
Specific contract lang po, kaysa related po yan, dahil kapag retainer po, normally kasama po dyan yung pagiging corporate secretary. Hindi po ako nagtatanggap sa corporate secretary work na unang-una dahil medyo semi-retired na po ako. Hindi naman ako talaga tumatanggap ng maraming kaso. At yung sa kwento lang ni Cassie, talagang alam ko po maraming nagsamantala sa kanila. From yung kaso nila sa ejectment, yung nagpaupa sa kanila, na napakamahal ang paupa, lahat po talaga parang napagsamantalahan sila pagdating na pati dito sa salili nilang representante sa PAGCOR.
Sabi nyo, marami nagsamantala po sa kanila. Is that what you're saying?
Yes po. Kaya nga po, medyo naawa ako nung nalaman ko yung mga kwento nila, no? Dahil from the amount of valuation dun sa property na liblib na liblib, binalyo po nila ng 20,000 per square meter, no? Tapos yung mga pangyayari po na umusbong kung bakit kinailangan pumasok sa kaso, nagsimula po talaga upa lang yan. Tapos, pinilit silang bilin. Nangako naman yung ama na, sige, bilin nyo na, ako magbabayad sa first year ng installment basis. Hindi naman tinumpad ng ama. At syempre, wala silang capacity to pay, no? So, kaya nga po nagkaroon ng kasukasuhan.
But you know na they are involved in the POGO operation.
Alam ko po na yung property na naging kasukasuhan ay pinapaupahan sa POGO.
Therefore, Tony Roque, the reason why siguro pinaupahan ng malaki yung property sapagkat alam nung may-ari na itong si Cassandra involved sa POGO ito?
Well, hindi po. Alam niya na siya talaga yung umuupa sa kanya. Dahil lesser naman po si Cruz, siya po ay lessee, no? At ito namang Lucky South ay sub-lessee. So, totoo po, malaki talaga ang mga naging valuation kasi alam nila na papaupahan sa POGO. At kung walang POGO, wala pong balur talaga yung property na yon dahil liblib.
For the purpose of just fully recording this hearing today, ano po ba yung serbisyo ninyo na binabayaran po nila kung wala silang pending case sa anumang court?
Meron po. Tatlo po ang kasong hinaharap ko ngayon. Apat pa pala, no? Meron pong Court of Appeals. Nagkaroon po ng issue sa Angeles Regional Trial Court. At yung ejectment case po ay binalik na sa Metropolitan Trial Case. At meron pa pong isang kasong kriminal na umusbong po dahil nga dun sa compromise agreement na napirmahan na hindi nasunod. So, apat po yung kasong na nakabinbin sa hukuman.
Pero hindi po kayo kinukontrata para gamitin po kayong impluensya sa mga taong nasa gobyerno?
Hindi po. Puro kaso po yan. At alam naman po ng mga West sa San Fernando, sa Angeles, sa Porac, na ako mismo ang umaapir po dyan.
After all this, Attorney Roque, of course, you are in this hearing today because of the POGO problem, no? Kung hindi kayo na-involve sa POGO, wala kayo rito eh.
Well, ang problema po kasi talaga, involve yung Whirlwind, no? Dahil siya po talaga yung nagpapaupa dito sa Porac. Actually, meron po kayo hindi naimbitahan po, Mr. Chair. Yung landowner na nagsimula ng lahat ng problemang ito, hindi ko maintindihan po bakit hindi naimbitahan yung landowner na Cruz. Dahil ang pagkakaalam ko rin po talaga, siya rin talaga nag-orchestrate ang lahat para matuloy yung negosyo nila. Tapos in the end, lumalabas, nasa anak pala niya yung titulo, no?
Wait, Mr. Chairman, Harry, Bienvenido Abante, medyo, sino po yung may-ari, si Cruz?
Yes, a certain Mr. Cruz at saka yung mga anak po niya na nagdidimandahan po
if
sila.
If I am not mistaken, I was able to read that this parcel of land were at first was leased, di ba?
Leased
then,
po.
Eventually, it was sold?
Leased po, linis po nung Roberto Cruz. It turns out, wala palang titulo si Roberto Cruz dahil nasa anak niya yung titulo. Kaya po, nagkaroon ng compromise agreement, nag-ejectment case. Dan po nagbunga ejectment case kasi yung mga anak ang nag-file ng kaso for ejectment.
Mm-hmm.
At yung ama, ang version naman ng Whirlwind, hindi sinabi sa kanila, kumuha ng sariling abogado, at hindi sinabi sa kanila na nagkakasuhan na, at nalaman na lang nila na nagkaroon na ng decision ng Regional Trial Court na meron ng writ of execution. At dun po kami tinawag.
Mr. Chair, okay. Therefore, I'd like to make a motion that we invite the next hearing
so
the owner
be,
of the property.
Yes.
And I do not know why the chairman of PACO right now, Altenco, is not here, no? I also would like to make a motion.
He promised naman in the next hearing he'll be here. But if you have question, andiyan si Attorney Fernandez.
I would like to first make a motion first to invite Mr. Cruz.
Yes.
The revelation of Attorney Roque.
There's a motion to invite the Cruz brothers ba yan? Or Cruz isa lang yan?
Cruz family po yan kasi nagdidimandahan po sila. Yung ama
siblings.
Ay Roberto. Doon po sa pleadings na inurnish ko kayo, nandun po yung mga pangalan ng anak. Ang dimandahan po talaga dyan is yung mga anak versus yung tatay.
Oh, so we will just be asking siguro yung... excuse me. Sa relation ng mga criminal elements that meron po silang involvement because precisely the reason why we conducted this hearing is for the criminal activities that transpired, no? But in accordance with what Attorney Roque mentioned a while ago na sila ang nag-conceptualize kasama yung mga Roberto Cruz, that we have to find out. Kaya medyo medyo nag-react ako dun sa sinabi niya because I didn't know that na sila yung nagsimulang mag-conceptualize nung buong proyekto. And in that case, most likely, they are also involved. So, motion, jury seconded. Any second motion? Second motion. Is there any objection? Hearing none, the said motion is now approved. So, invite those personalities.
Hey,
go ahead. You proceed, Chair would like to recognize, to acknowledge the presence of the 2nd District Congressman ng Aklan, si Ted Haresco. Sir, welcome.
Attorney Roque, kapatid.
Yes,
I'm calling
Mr. Chair.
You kapatid, no?
Yes,
because I think you know why.
Yes, my bishop. Yes po.
Okay. Ngayon, therefore, your involvement with POGO is not only being a lawyer of the corporation. Medyo malalim ang involvement mo sa POGO. Am I right?
Hindi po, kasi kasakusahan po yung aking involvement. Naubos po ang oras namin kasi pumasok kami, meron ng writ of execution. So talagang 2 weeks after that meeting po, talagang we had to pour in lots of hours dahil we had to stop the execution issued by the Regional Trial Court of Angeles City.
Hindi rin po kayo investor sa POGO?
Hindi po.
Alright. Now, after all this, lahat ng mga bagay na ito, will you still allow yourself to be used?
Well,
by the Whirlwind Corporation, after knowing this, after na iniimbisigan po ng Senado ito, ng Kongreso ito, will you still allow yourself to be the lawyer or be used by this corporation?
Mr. Chair, hinahawakan ko po mga kaso naman.
And you can always say, because you are involved in POGO, I'm withdrawing my being a lawyer to you.
Well,
do you have the right to do that? I'm not a lawyer, so I'd like to find out.
Sa mga papeles po, ang hinahawakan ko lang talaga yung issue po ng possession. So, wala pong kinalaman ang POGO doon sa mga kasuhan namin. It's an ordinary ejectment case. I would like to think na we were relatively successful at kaya po natagalan din ako magdesisyon kung tatanggapin ang kaso kasi suntok sa buwan. Ang final po namin eventually sa Court of Appeals ay petition to annul judgment, no? Na hanggang ngayon po ay nakabingbin sa Court of Appeals.
I do realize that, pero because of those cases, tatagal yan. At imbis na the government can do something about it, hindi talaga nila magagawa ang dapat nilang gawin because there's are cases against them.
Well, Mr. Chair, sabihin na lang natin na nag-aantay kami ng decision sa Court of Appeals. Pagkatapos po dyan, we need to get fresh instructions. Eh, ang problema ko, wala na po dito si Cassandra Ong ata. Hindi ko na rin makontak, no? So kapag hindi ko po na makontak na yan, we have no choice but to tell the court that we are withdrawing because of the fact that we have lost contact with them, no?
You do not know where she is now.
Well, hindi ko na po alam talaga kung nasaan siya, no? In fact, I have demanded that she come back in the few instances na nakakausap ko siya dahil sabi ko nga, I cannot be left to defend you on matters that I do not know. Ang hinawakan ko lang, kaso, at saka yung sinamahan kita para sa rescheduling of payment. Wala na akong alam at lumalabas naman po talaga sa Senado na wala naman ako kinalaman sa kanila, no, until 2023, no, kung saan nagsimula rin yung mga kaso shortly after sinamahan ko sila sa Pancor.
Inanong nyo rin po yung mga partners kung nasaan na si Cassandra and they don't even know where he is.
Ang kakilala ko lang po talaga si Cassandra at yung time na nagkoconvince ako sa kanila na mag-invest sa solar, meron pong Singaporean who is not a resident of the Philippines who comes and goes and talks to me. Siya po talaga yung dahilan kaya hindi ko rin sila napa-invest kasi hindi siya believe dun sa binigay na PSA ng Meralco dun sa project sa Cebu.
I just want to know your feeling, no, Attorney Roque, an advocacy, no, being a professed Christian. So do you believe that gambling should be in the Philippines?
I have always been against gambling po.
You have always been against
that? I've always been against gambling. I was raised as a Christian. My mother was president of the Philippine Temperance Union. I do not gamble, not even cards. I have no vices. And I do not approve of POGO. I have said that I hope POGO will completely be banned. And I hope we adopt the legislation of the United States which absolutely prohibits any form of gambling that will be transmitted from the U.S. to other jurisdictions.
So you, fully support the president in his declaration of banning POGO in the Philippines?
I 100% support that, and I hope there will be no exception to it.
But when you were still working with the former president who has actually supported POGO, what is your feeling about that?
Well, I had to say what was in the president's mind as a presidential spokesperson, which was very difficult. But as I said, I had to defend why POGOs were open during quarantine and churches were not, which was very difficult. And it's a thankless job.
It means
sometimes
that,
I think, Mr. Chair, I should never have left this house.
Okay, it means that you are willing to set aside your being a Christian.
Hindi naman po.
I am willing. Yun ang aking paningin. Look, Tony Roque, I supported you when you were a pro-senator.
Well,
you were even in my church.
Well, yes po.
And almost all the Baptist churches in the Philippines, 6,000 of them supported you actually.
Yes, Your Honor.
Because I believe in your advocacy. Now, you are telling me that you are willing to set aside your being a Christian because you're the spokesman of the former president. Is that what I hear right now?
Hindi po. Hindi po nagbago ang aking mga paninindigan. In fact, yung issue dito sa House nung nandito ako, yung mga miyembro po ng 17th Congress, alam nila yung mga issue gaya ng death penalty, lowering of age of criminality, bumoto po ako sang-ayon sa aking pananampalataya. So, meron pong distinction yung mga personal na paninindigan ko at yung aking katungkulan bilang isang spokesperson. Kaya nga po, bagamat ang aking presidente ay pabor sa death penalty, hindi po nagbagong personal na paninindigan ko na ako po ay tutol. Ganyan din po ang usapin ng kasino at pogos. Kasi sa akin po, walang pagkakaiba ang pogo, walang pagkakaiba ang kasino, pare-pareho po yan. Walang mabuting gagawa, lahat po yan ay labag, no, sa utos ng Panginoon. Pero yung paninindigan ko pong personal, hindi po yan nagbabago. Pero kung trabaho at ikaw ay spokesperson, hindi naman po pwede nang lalabas sa bibig mo ay sarili mong paninindigan at hindi paninindigan ng presidente. Pero consistent po ako na talagang a matter of record when I was here in the House, I voted pursuant to my conviction as a Filipino and as a Christian.
Last question. Naniniwala po kayo sa katabihan na walang personal na ito, trabaho lamang ito.
Opo, naintindihan ko po dahil alam ko naman mahal niyo ako bilang iyong isang tupa bishop.
You're against all forms of gambling. Is that one I'm trying to say here?
Mr. Chair, yes. I have never engaged in gambling. I don't even play cards. Ganyan po ako pinalaki in a Baptist family. in a
last question,
UCCP family po.
Congressman Al.
Mr. Chair.
Abante.
You don't play cards. Mayroon sa solitaire kayo, di ba?
Hindi, di ko po alam kung paano maglaro po ng solitaire. Yan po, ganun
ako, marunong po. Ako eh. Solitaire.
Mr. Chair, mas mabuti pa si Bishop. Ako hindi ako marunong.
Okay, Mr. Chair. Thank you. Isang question lang, not for Tony Roque, but we have an officer here of the League of Municipalities.
Yes,
like
si Paul.
Ask, because I see my friend here, Mayor Batawil, no? I'd like to find out, Mayor Batawil, on your being the president yata of the League of Municipalities, no? Vice president, no? In Pangasinan, for example, do you know of any municipality that has a Pogo Hub in it? And my second question is it legal or illegal? That's what you find out.
Your Honor, we are guided by the existing rules and regulations, and we are aware that and it has been confirmed by the State of the Nation address by the President that POGOs are illegal except for those who had been granted by the PAGCOR, no? Which were given up to December of this year to wind up. And on that note, the list of POGO involved municipalities were given to us. And the list is with our Secretariat of LMP. Your Honor, sir.
Yeah, do you have in Pangasinan alone, do you have municipalities that are quite involved in having a POGO hub?
Your Honor, I have to refer to the list which had been given to us because that is based on some facts and evidence. And as personally, my mind is will just be a conjecture. But based on the list that had been submitted, maybe I can base my answer to your question, Your Honor.
Is there any? I would think that there are POGO hubs in Pangasinan. Am I right? So if there are, I would like to ask if there is a relationship with Alice Goo dyan, the mga POGO hubs na yan.
Ko po alam kasi like her, I am also from the farm. but I'm aware of some reports involving Pangasinan, Your Honor.
Ngayon ko lang nalaman yun, ha? Okay, some barbers.
If I may,
go
ahead. I was following your questioning, Congressman Abante. Perhaps we can ask Mayor Batawil if he knows if there is a mayor who is romantically involved with Mayor Alice Goo from Pangasinan.
That's a revelation to me, Congressman Barber. I'd like to find out, is there?
Your Honor. Hindi po ako yun. It had been said many times over that subject had been linked to a Pangasinan mayor. Pero hindi po ako yun. Your Honor.
Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you.
So that will be the last
question. Mr. Chair, even before...
Wait. That will be the last question. You want to interject
something? Yeah, Mr. Chair, I'm just asking, wala na ngayon. Or meron before, or...
Ewan ko. Mamaya na kayo mag-usap.
Congresswoman Janet, why are you interested?
Mr. Chair.
Okay, we need some funny moments, but there's another interjection from Congressman Akop. Sir, you are recognized.
I'll just follow up the question of the Honorable Abate.
Of course. I think that will be a funny moment. Go ahead.
Mayor Batawil.
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes. You're from Pangasinan, right? The mayor of Lingayen?
Yes, Your Honor.
Do you know the mayor of Sual, Pangasinan?
Yes, Your Honor. He is a member of our chapter.
Is the rumor true?
Your Honor, like you, as a former policeman, I base my statement on evidence.
And you do not have any evidence?
At the moment, personally, I do not have, Your Honor.
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Oh, I said so. Okay, so we will be proceeding to the next interpellator. But before I recognize Congresswoman Luistro, the Chair would like to acknowledge the presence of the Lone District Congresswoman of San Jose del Monte City, Representative Florida Rida Robes. Okay, yan. Ma'am, you are now recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. With all due respect to Attorney Harry Roque, I always yield to your legal expertise. However, Attorney Roque, this is one of the occasions when my knowledge in law became gray. So I wish to ask once more for the record. With all due respect, kayo po ba ay abogado ng Lucky South 99?
Hindi po. Wala po akong attorney-client relationship sa kahit sino na shareholder or officer ng Lucky Star.
From that Lucky answer South of Attorney Roque, Mr. Chair, I wish to share to the committee the case of Eusebio Season versus Attorney Lourdes Dumlao. This is AC number 11959, April 28, 2021. If I may quote, a lawyer-client relationship is established when lawyers consistently manifest to a person consulting them that they would provide legal representation or assistance, regardless of the close ties between the parties, or the lack of written contract, or the non-payment of legal fees. It is very clear, Mr. Chair, that from the definition of a lawyer-client relationship, kahit walang kontrata, kahit walang payment of legal fees, the moment the client starts seeking advice and the lawyer starts giving advice, a client-attorney relationship is created. Can we be enlightened on this, Mr. Chair, from Attorney Roque?
Attorney Roque, you are now recognized.
Mr. Chair, tama po yun. Ang problema, wala pong kahit anong konsulta na nangyari sa panig ko at sa kahit kanino sa panig po ng Lucky South. Kaya miski wala pong bayad, wala pong kontrata, wala rin po kaming komunikasyon. Dahil ang komunikasyon ko po, lahat po yan ay kikasi ong lamang.
I understand, Mr. Chair, that a statement of Attorney Roque, he was never consulted by Lucky South 99. But he has been repeating a while ago that Cassandra Lee Ong is the representative of Lucky South 99. Is it not that the consultations made by Representative Ong with Attorney Roque, the consultations as well that was made by Lucky South 99 with Attorney Roque, Mr. Chair?
Mr. Chair, gaya na aking sinabi po kanina, ang aking attorney-client relationship ay kay Cassandra Ong at kay Whirlwind. Dahil sila po ay umakto bilang ahente ng Lucky South, pero hindi ko po naging kliyente ang Lucky South. Para po siguro malinaw, it is an instance where both Whirlwind and Lucky South will benefit kung magtutuloy ang negosyo ng Lucky South. Kasi kung wala naman po Lucky South, useless yung pinatayong premises ng Whirlwind. At kung wala naman ang Whirlwind, wala rin uupahan ang Lucky South. Pero pagdating po sa attorney-client relationship, dapat meron man lang komunikasyon sa panig ng amuka abogado at ng kliyente whether or not there is a written agreement, whether or not there is bayad. Pero wala po talagang ganun dahil limited lang ako kay Cassie Ong.
Mr. Chair, I just wish to remind our resource speaker that I think there were three members of the committee who have been delving on this question, and repeatedly, Attorney Roque stated that he is lawyering for Cassandra Ong. Cassandra Ong is the representative of Lucky South 99. And it is really hard to conceive how he can separate himself from Lucky South 99 if his client is representing no less than Lucky South 99. Lucky South is not a natural person. It is a juridical person. The only way to talk with a lawyer is through a representative, and that is Cassandra Ong. If I may add, Mr. Chair, under Section 3 of Canon 3, lawyer-client relationship. A lawyer-client relationship, yes, Attorney Roque is correct, the highest fiduciary character. As a trust relation, it is essential that the engagement is founded on the confidence reposed by the client on the lawyer. Therefore, a lawyer-client relationship shall arise when the client consciously, voluntarily, and in good faith vests a lawyer with a client's confidence for the purpose of rendering legal services such as providing legal advice, representation, and the lawyer, whether expressly or impliedly, agrees to render such services. There are two elements, Mr. Chair. The first element is that the client solicits advice and service of the lawyer. And the second element, the lawyer renders service and advice to the client. I think in the given situation, both were fulfilled. There is Cassandra Ong, or there was Cassandra Ong, representing the juridical person, Lucky South 99, who solicited the advice, the service of Attorney Harry Roque. And Attorney Harry Roque physically accompanied Cassandra Ong to PAGCOR, a manifestation of his act of rendering service and advice to his client. I humbly submit, Mr. Chair, that I think there are sufficient legal provisions to establish that a lawyer-client relationship was indeed created with Lucky South 99, Mr. Chair.
You want to reply on that, former Secretary Roque?
Mr. Chair, I can only say that as a lawyer, I have a different opinion. I acknowledge that there is lawyer-client relationship between me and Cassie Ong as representative of Whirlwind, who in turn acted as agent for Lucky South. But that does not mean that Lucky South gave me their trust and confidence to represent me. And I would repeat it, kung kukunin po nila ako to quash the raid on their property, I will readily accept it. Pero yun nga po, hindi nila gagawin yun. Dahil sa tingin nila, ang kritiko ng gobyerno, hindi magpapanalo ng kaso sa kanila, magpapalala pa. Yun lang po ang sitwasyon talaga.
Mr. Chair, earlier, Attorney Roque likewise stated that Whirlwind is the agent of Lucky South. Does our resource speaker confirm this, Mr. Chair?
Yes po.
And can agency be implied?
Well, it can be implied, but an agency, once delegated, cannot be further delegated. Yun po ang rule.
Can it be done verbally?
Well, agency is written or verbal. Pero ang sinasabi ko nga po, yung delegated authority to Cassie Ong cannot be delegated any further. Ang pwede lang po mag-delegate talaga ay yung principal.
And what therefore is your concrete basis why you reached the conclusion that Whirlwind is an agent of Lucky South 99?
Well, una-una, Mr. Chair, because that is how Whirlwind explained it to me. And under the circumstance na sila nagpapaupa ng property nila at may interest sila na magkapatuloy ang negosyo ng Lucky South, nakita ko naman po kung ano interest din ng Whirlwind. Ang interest ng Whirlwind ay magpatuloy po ang negosyo nung nag-uupa sa kanila, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair, I want to go to the basic. Agency is a contract where there are two parties involved, the agent and the principal. It is hard to conceive, Mr. Chair, that Attorney Roque will be relying on the representation only of Whirlwind without an active participation of the other party, who is supposed to be the principal, the Lucky South 99. And even assuming that indeed Whirlwind is an agent of Lucky South, I hope we are reminded as well by the principle that the act of the agent is the act of the principal, and the liability of the agent is the liability of the principal. Similar to attorney-client relationship, there is a fiduciary relationship that is existing between the principal and the client. So I wish to conclude, Mr. Chair, that Attorney Roque's representation did not cover only the Whirlwind, but extends even to Lucky South, Mr. Chair.
Para sa iba pang karagdagang mga balita at impormasyon, ay huwag po nating kalimutang mag-like, share at comment sa video na ito, at huwag po rin nating kalimutang mag-subscribe to continue supporting us. Maraming salamat po sa inyong panonood, at naway tangkilikin po ninyo ang aming YouTube channel.